Hello everyone, you are all welcome to lecture number 906, and today's topic is some special type of pens. And these special type of pens are, for example, latex pens. In latex pens, the synthetic resin or rubber like latex is emulsified with thinner vehicle, that is linseed oil, that is called latex pen. Second one, that is illuminescent pen, or we can say fluorescent pen. They produce light in presence of the fluorescence in presence of ultraviolet light. And these substances which are producing fluorescence in presence of ultraviolet light, they are actually sulfides of zinc and cadmium. In presence of magnesium, manganese, boron, like that. And the third one is called fire resistant pens. They can resist fire, and they are manufactured in such a way that once the place where it is painted, if it catch fire, the binder will be broken, the paint binder, and after the breaking the binder, the broken portion will start producing carbon dioxide gas, ammonia gas, hydrochloric acid gas, hydrogen bromide gas, even water vapor, and these gases are capable to put out the fire or immediately stop the fire. The third one is called, that is called heat resistant pens. Heat resistant pens are such type of pens that even if it is red heat, it can be resisted. And these pens, they contain actually base metallic powders, like aluminium, like zinc powder, and they can resist the heat. So in this way, there are these special type of pens, and there are some special application of pens also, like butamine paint. That one is painted to stop the rusting and decaying. Some paints are there which are applied to ship so that corrosion will not be there. So like these are all, I am going to tell one by one. So these are the special type of paints. Number one, that is latex paints. The major vehicle of film forming material in latex paint is mainly synthetic resin. Latex in an oil water immersion and is a type of system where the vehicles may or may not be present in the latex paint. Number two, luminescent paint. Actually, luminescent paint is manufactured in such a way by adding some color modifying agent, and some agents, they can absorb ultraviolet light short wavelength, and then they can convert into our visible range of that light. So that will give the fluorescence. That is called illuminescent paints. So these paints contain pigments which fluoresces under the influence of ultraviolet light, and they are mainly zinc sulfide or the sulfide of cadmium with a small amount of color modifier. So there are some elements they can modify the color, and these elements are such as copper, silver, manganese, and boron, that is Cu, Ag, Mn, and B. And these are the best example of luminophore pigments which absorb ultraviolet light from other short wavelength radiations and emit radiation in visible range of the spectrum. The visible or daylight color is somewhat different from the luminescent paint. Number three, fire resistant paints. These paints contain such type of materials called binders, and these binders, they break once it will catch fire, which break down at high temperature and produce non-inflammable gases. And non-inflammable gases, they are mainly the halide gases, like hydrogen halide means that is HCl, hydrochloric acid, HBr, hydrobromic acid, carbon dioxide gas, ammonia gas, and also water, that is water, vapor. These are all barrier of inflammable gases to check and to stop them. These gases can dilute inflammable gases produced by the breakdown of the other components of the paint. Chlorinated rubber, polyvinyl chloride, alkyds, and epoxides, they are the component they break down to produce non-inflammable hydrogen halides. And these non-inflammable hydrogen halides are produced by PVC, by chlorinated rubber, and by epoxides. Then non-inflammable hydrogen halides are produced. Paints containing magnesium phosphate, zinc ammonium pyrophosphate, calcium ammonium phosphate can melt and prevent the combustion by standing as a barrier between inflammable and non-inflammable gases. So these components, if it is there in the paint, it will also that resist the fire. And these components, I have already told you, that is your magnesium phosphate, zinc ammonium pyrophosphate, and calcium ammonium phosphate. These are all the So the fourth one is, that is heat resistant paints. The paints which is resisting heat even up to a red heat, that very high heat, are called heat resistant paints. And these paints generally contain base metallic powders, and these base metallic powders are like aluminium powder, zinc powder, tin powder, graphite powder, titania powder, and chromia powder. So these powders are used to manufacture the heat resistant paint. The some paints also contain polyphenyl silicones also. These paints are generally used in furnaces, iron, steels, aircraft, combustion chambers, diesel engine, exhaust pipe. Number five, special applications of paints. How there are special type of application. A, paints are extensively used as acid resistant coat. So first point is that all the paints what we are coating, they are mainly used as an acid resistant coat. B, iron bound water paints, or commonly which is called as distempers. So these distempers are widely used for interior decoration of our walls and houses. That's why it is called distempers. See, coal tar products dissolved in mineral spirits, that is spirits, have been used as protective coating of pipes under the name of bituminous paint. So bituminous paint means where coal tar bitumen is dissolved in your spirit, and that is called bituminous paint, and that is widely used as a protective coating in the pipes. D. Ship bottoms are protected by anti-flowing paints. So anti-flowing paint, which is prepared by mixing iron oxide, mercuric oxide and copper resinate, dispersed in tungsten iron, that is vacuum. So once these materials, oxide, that is iron, mercury and copper, resinate, which is dissolved or dispersed in tungsten iron, and it is used to paint the bottom of the ship to avoid the corrosion. E. A paint with damp resisting properties can be prepared by mixing paraffin wax, bitumen dispersed in tungsten iron, and this paint is called damp resistant paint. There are several methods of application of paints. They are brushing or hand painting, then spraying with nozzle on the wall. This is very fast method of applying the paint. Then dipping method, then roller coating method with the very common nowadays roller painting, and then tumbling. These are all methods by means of which we can apply the paints. So with this I will stop here, and next lecture will be, that is under pigment and paint industry, that is the manufacture of varnishes. With this, thank you very much for watching the lecture.